felt like God's asked you to do something and you didn't know if you were qualified to do it. Maybe you felt like you didn't have the resources or you didn't have the ability. Or maybe there's some things that are burning in your heart you want to say yes to, but you just don't see how you can get it to the finished product, how you can make it to the end of the line. You know, I think there will be times in life that we all stand against obstacles that seem insurmountable, almost impossible. There was a man, his name is Moses. We all know the story of Moses, and he was a great leader. He was a man who led God's people, the Israelites, out of captivity, out from under the hard oppression of Pharaoh. When he was up against obstacles like the Red Sea, he lifted his staff and that sea parted so that he could take the people through on dry land. As they were in the wilderness, they were thirsty, and God allowed him to take his staff once more and strike a rock so the people's thirst could be quenched. Moses was an amazing leader. He was a great man. He was a man that we look at today and think, wow, God, you used him. He did mighty exploits for you. In fact, I believe we're all here today on a different path with a different destiny because of Moses' leadership. But do you know, Moses didn't start out that way. When Moses met God in a burning bush and God approached him and told him what his assignment was, the first thing out of Moses' mouth was, I can't, God. And he began to tell God all the reasons that he wasn't the man God thought he was. He began to make excuses like, I stutter. They won't listen to me, God. I'm sure as he was making his excuses, he thought to himself, well, you know, I have a past in Egypt. I can't go back there. But you know, as he was making these excuses to God, God said to Moses, who made your mouth? He was saying, Moses, you're not man-made. You weren't created by man. You were God-made. I have put everything in you that you'll ever need. You are fully loaded. You are equipped and well able to do what I've called you to do. Moses was trying to get in alignment with God, but he couldn't seem to get on the same page. As he was continuing to tell God these excuses, God met him with this promise. He said, Moses, now go. Go and I will teach you what to say. I will lead you and tell you how to do it. You see, God wasn't put off with Moses' excuses. He wasn't even put off with the fact that Moses felt weak, insecure. He wanted Moses to know that he was not alone. So he gave him the promise, I will teach you. I will show you. I will lead you. I will make you the leader I've called you to be. You see, if you've ever felt like Moses, and there's some things in your life that you know you want to do, maybe break some bad habits, maybe step up to a new level, can I tell you that God can turn that I can't into an I can? You see, God is an I can God, and he wants us to be I can people. The same promise he spoke to Moses, he's speaking to you. He will lead you. He will guide you. He will tell you what to say. In fact, when you get in front of that Red Sea, God's going to say, what is in your hand? Lift it up right now, because I'm about to part this Red Sea so that you can go through on dry ground. You see, just like Moses, he had a staff. God has given you something in your hand. But we have to be I can people. You know, Paul said it like this in Philippians, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. See, he knew as long as he was connected to the power source, as long as he was dependent on God, God had already put in him everything he need. And if he didn't have it, he was going to make sure, God was going to make sure he gets it. You see, you can today. You can break an addiction. You can have good relationships. You can succeed in life. You can start that business. You can get that promotion. You can be a good mother. You can do all things through Christ because He is your power source. He's your power source. Listen, I want to encourage us all today. I can is a promise from God. It's a powerful phrase that if you will get in your heart, you will see amazing things happen in your life. Just like Paul said, I can, I want you to begin to say, I can, I can, I can, I can. When the enemy comes against you with doubt and unbelief and wants you to say, but I can't, I don't have the resources, the ability, the qualifications, you turn that I can't into an I can. Because let me tell you, just like it wasn't really about Moses, it was about what God wanted to do through Moses. God wants to do something great through you. But until you let go of the I can, you can never pick up the I can. Today, if you feel weak, if you feel insecure, you say, I like this message. I do like this message. I do hope that I can do that. I want you to know you're in good company. Jonah, he couldn't do it. He didn't think he was able. Oh, Gideon, he was weak. He thought he was the least in all his family. Peter, on and on. But you know what God says? Go and I'll teach you. Go and I'll show you the way. He said, you know what he said to Gideon? He said, go, Gideon, in the strength that you have. That means you have what it takes right now. Our assignment is to put one step in front of the other, one foot in front of the other. Our assignment is go, and God will do the rest if we'll stay in line with Him, connected to His power source. I want to pray for you right now. I want us to make a declaration that when we feel the pressure, when we see the Red Sea, when we see those walls that look impossible, when we're overwhelmed and we don't know what to do, we have an I can, a yes to God on the inside of us. Father, I thank you right now for every person. At the sound of my voice, Father, you have made them. You have molded them, and they are becoming a great leader, a vessel in your hands. Now, Father, you don't get upset with us when we feel weak, when we're intimidated, but God, you give us that confidence with your word, and through your word, I will make you, I will help you, I will. God, thank you that we do have a rod in our hand, that we can lift up the word of God where we are right now against every obstacle, and that obstacle cannot stand. I thank you, Father, that you will cause our crooked places to become straight. I thank you, Father, that you will bring good people along our path, that you will give us everything we need, Father. I thank you that you've already got the resources lined up. We just need to keep going, keep moving, and keep walking. And Father, you said when we don't know what to say, that you would speak through us. Thank you for creative ideas coming through us. Thank you, the answers are coming through us. The wisdom is coming through us. Father, we are not I can't people, but we are I can people, and we declare it so in Jesus' name. And if you believe it, shout a great big amen.
Thanks for watching this message. I hope you enjoyed it. We upload new videos every week to keep you inspired and encouraged. So don't forget to hit the like button and make sure you subscribe to our channel.
Let us know in the comments below how this message has encouraged you. We would love to hear from you. We're praying for you and your family. We'll see you next time.